Hey guys, in this video I'll be showing you the best way to beat this Shattered Thrones Ogre encounter solo on a Warlock, Titan, and Hunter. So let's get started. I'll be switching up my loadout for each character, and this encounter allows you to be pretty flexible with the weapons you choose. The only thing I would avoid doing is making your Void Energy weapon one that takes special ammo. Since the wizards are a pain to kill, you don't want to find yourself having to scavenge around the map for special ammo. Other than that, the only weapons I think you should definitely use are going to be the exotics in my heavy slot. If you're struggling in any other part of the fight besides the damage phase, feel free to copy my loadouts and see if any of them work good for you. Thanks to the recent patch, there is a ridiculously easy way to one-phase Vorgeth all by yourself on a Warlock, so that's where we'll start. If you're going for a flawless run, definitely try using the Warlock's Well of Radiance super. Not only does this subclass come with a giant healing well, but you also get a grenade that you can use to heal yourself, as well as your standard healing rift. This could also be applied to just a normal solo run or just normally going through the Shattered Throne. Well of Radiance is awesome. The weapons I chose to roll with on my Warlock here were Threat Level, a rapid fire shotgun from the Scourge of the Past raid, the Inaugural Address, one of my personal favorites for this fight, which is a year one pulse rifle from the Leviathan raid, and in the heavy slot I'm rocking the Legend of Acrius, something I haven't touched in a long time, but the last patch made this weapon a monster for burst damage. Trust me, it's nuts when you see it in action. Now I'm also pairing this loadout with the Lunafaction boots exotic so I never have to reload inside of my well or rift. Something I would suggest using is 5 Transcendent Blessing mods, one for each armor piece. These are the Dreaming City mods that drop from Purification Ritual bounties for completing certain activities like Ascendant challenges or just doing things Ascendant. These are super helpful for the throne and definitely provide a good boost to your damage in the activity, so try and stack up on those if you want to have a much easier time. Although they're not necessary at all, as you'll see on my Hunter run, but I am using 5 of them here on my Warlock. So the meat of the encounter is played roughly the same as I would always play it, always being aware of my surroundings and the positions of the enemies, and always utilizing cover. Probably my favorite strategy in this room is to first clear the enemies by where I drop down, and then either start lowering down the wizard's health or moving on to the next group of enemies. Instead of trying to kill each wizard and then each group of enemies right away, your best option, since you aren't timed until you pick up the buff, is to take it slow and work on getting rid of all of the taken vandals and goblins first, before worrying about the wizards. Often I try and get each wizard low before I move on to the next group, but the order doesn't really matter. The goal is to end up with at least 3 wizards that are very low health. Although, as you'll see in the runs on my other characters, sometimes it's helpful to actually clear the enemies in the back of the room, and even get the 4th wizard low if you find yourself not having enough time. Once at least the 3 wizards closest to you are low health, I like to start by killing the one closest to the entrance, picking up the buff, and working my way clockwise around the room. This means the left wizard will be next, then the back wizard, then the right wizard, which is where I'll do the damage from. The reason I do this is because the last wizard is pretty far from the group of snipers that spawn in behind the ogre's position. But it's also not too close to the corner of the room where this annoying minotaur spawns that's part of the Wish Ender quest. If you're too close to the corner, sometimes he wanders up and starts smacking you and then runs away. You can actually kill him if you want, but I wouldn't worry about him too much. I'd focus on doing damage over anything else. Essentially, the way this one phase strategy works is once you extinguish the petitioner's burden buff, you want to get close to the boss and slam down your well before all of his axes on dart things hit you. Once you place down your well, the boss is going to want to do a slam attack. Once he does this, try and time your melee so that when he slams the ground, you're punching him so that you don't go flying backwards. And make sure you're in your well, and then try and aim for his eye. Try and pay attention to when he's about to slam, because if you don't counter it with a melee, the knockback will send you out of the rift, and you'll lose the potential for a one phase. Like you'll see in the footage, Legend of Acrius absolutely demolishes the boss and turns him into a joke. This gun is an absolute monster now, and will really help you speedrun through the fight solo. And I can only imagine how awesome this looks with a full fire team. You probably kill him in like 3 seconds. So for the other classes, the main strategy is pretty similar, just with different loadouts and subclasses. But if you're looking to see how I beat Vorgeth on a Titan and a Hunter, and what I use for them, feel free to watch the rest of the video. The strategies and setup I used on all of these characters were by far the easiest for me, and hopefully you guys can get comfortable with one of them, and get your first solo clear, or just learn how to get good at the Shattered Throne. Vorgeth is by far the hardest part for me, and it's the one I've spent the most time practicing and trying to refine strategies for. In the next video, I'll be covering the easiest ways to beat the final boss, class, Duel Inkaru for each class as well, so keep on the lookout for that one. Once that video's up, I'll put it in the end screen or have an annotation on the screen, and definitely a link in the description. Alright everyone, thank you very much for watching, and enjoy the rest of the video, and good luck on fighting Vorgeth in the Shattered Throne.
this. Thank you.